A billionaire has given us the best piece of advice on how to manage our finances and our life to become successful and rich in the long term. Want to know the advice? Keep watching. Lee Ka Shing is a Hong Kong-based business magnate, property developer, and an investor. He was Asia's richest man in 2015. As of 2020, he is the sixth richest in Asia with an estimated wealth of $27 billion. His life is a classic rags-to-riches story. Hence, the advice given by him to the youngsters is something that he applied on himself to get to the position that he is in today. So here is the advice by Lee Ka Shing to the youngsters on how to be financially successful and become rich in the long term. Hi, welcome to Das Views, where we learn something new through discussions and opinions. As per Lee Ka Shing, you should divide your monthly income into 5 set of funds. These funds should be 30, 20, 15, 10 and 25% of your income. The first set of funds are for living expenses. You should dedicate 30% of your income to this fund. This fund should be used for rent, food, transportation and living expenses. When you are young, you should not aim for a lavish lifestyle, but try to find a cheap but decent accommodation. This can be addressed by sharing apartments with friends or other persons. You can also opt to stay as paying guests or in hostels, concepts that are fairly common in countries like India. If you are living with parents, then you get to save that expense too. Mr. Lee Ka Shing also advises to avoid eating out unnecessarily. One should have a basic breakfast, lunch and dinner which includes vegetables. When young, vegetable gives us all the required nutrients and our body doesn't suffer with a basic diet. The second set of funds are for expanding our interpersonal circle. You should dedicate 20% of your income to this fund. This is the fund we use to network with others. Phone bills definitely comes under this fund. Also, we should take at least 2 people to lunch or dinner every month and pay for it. What kind of people should we take out? People who we think are wiser than us or richer than us or have helped us in our careers. People who we think work harder and smarter than us, and people who dare to dream big. By taking them out for lunch, we not only learn a lot from them, but also create a positive image of ours in their minds and increase our circle of influence. If we do this every month for a year, we will find that our circle of influence and reputation has improved a lot than the beginning of the year. The third set of funds are for learning. You should dedicate 15% of your income to this fund. We should use this fund to buy books every month. And yes, books are bought not to collect dust but to be read. And when we spend our hard-earned money to buy books in the early stage of our career, we feel compelled to read them. But yes, no fictional books please, where fairy tale Cinderella gets her Prince Charming. We should buy and read non-fiction, such as autobiographies, biographies, strategies, politics, history, etc. In addition, we should also use some of the money from this fund to attend training courses. Attending training programs not only helps learning wise but also gives us opportunity to meet many like-minded people and make friends. Reading books and attending training courses will help expand our intellect greatly. The fourth set of funds are for traveling. You should dedicate 10% of your income to this fund. We should use this fund to travel, especially overseas, once a year. Traveling overseas exposes us to a new culture, a new world, and overall a new experience. As we travel to many places and many countries and meet countless people along the way, this will help shape our perspective and will definitely help us grow a lot as a person. Traveling is not only an enjoyable leisure activity, it is also a subconscious learning activity. Learning while getting recharged, what more can one ask for? The fifth and final set of funds are for investing. You should dedicate 25% of your income to this fund. We should save at least this much in our savings account in the bank. Then we should use this fund as an initial startup capital for starting small businesses. Small businesses are the ones where we don't commit much money. So if we lose, we don't lose much. But if we gain, we not only gain profits but also gain confidence to undertake bigger businesses in future. This combination of saving plus investing in a few years will become our war chest for bad times and also ensure stability in our lives. So, for example, in the Indian context, you earn 20,000 rupees per month as your first salary. You should divide that into 5 funds. 30% or 6,000 rupees should be for living expenses. 20% or 4,000 rupees should be to increase your interpersonal or friend circle. 15% or 3,000 rupees should be kept aside for learning, to buy books and to attend training programs. 10% or 2,000 rupees, which is 24,000 a year, should be used for traveling overseas, and 25% or 5,000 rupees should be saved to be invested. Mr. Lee Kasing calls these activities as grinding and says we should keep on grinding for the initial few years. He says after grinding for a year, if your income has still not improved, then you have not improved as a person and should be ashamed of yourself. If your income has improved, you should keep on grinding. He also advises us to find a part-time job, preferably in sales, if our primary job is not sales. Sales, though challenging, teaches us a lot. It teaches us to sell dreams, ideas, and vision. It also helps us recognize what sells and what doesn't. These are very crucial life skills required in today's age. These advices may seem as simple as saying, if you want to get fit, go for a run and hit the gym every day. As simple as they seem, only a few manage to make it a long-term routine and get the desired results. This advice is also like that, simple in words but needs a strong willpower to be converted into a routine. Mr. Lee Kasing says, if we continue this grind, after a few years, we will begin to have a surplus of funds, our body will get stronger with proper nutrition, we will become expert in networking, we will make many influential friends who will help us in our career, and with better training and more experience, we will get opportunities for bigger projects and businesses. Isn't this a great advice from Lee Kasing, the Hong Kong-based billionaire who is valued at $27 billion? I am sure it is. Let me know your comments in the comments box below. Your suggestion regarding the videos is always welcome. Have a great day.